Hi, what's going on, guys? This is MJ from Dynamic Render Labs, and this is the third chapter of my D5 Reality course, which is about camera tracking and render matching in D5 Render. In this video, we learn how to get our scene ready in D5 Render, so we could render the video and later match it to our drone footage. If you want to know more about this course, please watch the introduction in the playlist. And if you learn anything new from this video, please like, comment, and subscribe. Let's get it started. So, we have our Mac scene ready with the new camera path. Time to connect it to D5 Render again. Let's press connect here. Wonderful. So I first go into the objects and hide the new Max, as we don't need it, we just want the camera back. Then I press play in 3ds Max here and check how it looks in D5 Render. The real-time camera switch shows the animation in action, which seems to be interesting. Now, in order to send camera animation here, first we should actually create a scene. This scene is very necessary, as it would be more accurate compared to the animation. So first, in Max, make sure the time indicator is at frame 0. Then, in D5 Render, create a scene here. Alright, now we should configure environment and effects. We don't need to match our color accurately now, but it's important to be close and especially match sun position. So for now, I can go into environment and face and tweak it a bit. I kinda adjust settings here to make it similar to what I see in the image. In all fairness, there are a lot of trees here and it feels different nonetheless. So it's not a bad idea to do it after you populate the scene. Also, AI atmosphere match can sometimes be handy. It's different scene to scene, but again, since we have to do most of the job in post-production, we can simply not care. The most important thing, as I have said before, is the shadows inside the image. As you can see, it's this way. Since the HDRI I'm using already has a sun, I choose follow HDRI to avoid duplicate suns. And I rotate it. I can even fill up the HDRI in case that works best. Finally, don't forget to save the changes.
Did you get any of that?
I advise against using ambient occlusion overlay, as it will cause some problems later. Now, before we move on, make sure you go to advanced camera setting and make the aspect ratio based on the video, which is 16 to 9. Before going to next step, we should decide how we are going to play this out. For example, mine is pretty simple. This is our project. This is where our house is located. I can easily use anything I see behind the house in the drone footage. Maybe the laptop image, in the bottom left corner. These areas have nothing to do with where my house is located, and it's pretty simple. But where does it get complicated? When we have areas we cannot use, like this area, full of building materials and dirt. So we have to cover them. But what about these trees? We cannot mask them, so we have to cover them as well. And how about these trees? Do we have to cover them too? Actually, yes. You see, it's important we have a good blending between reality and render. And there are two things we can do. One is fading, and two, placing on top of what already exists.
On top, I like it up on top.
For example, take a look at this video. You can stand under my umbrella. This is the first reel I made of this project. This was the D5 render's output, and this was how I matched it to main video. And even though the colors are yet to be matched, but these two are blended well. Here on top, I have faded the road in 3D model, the actual road in the footage. Or here and bottom, these trees are now located on top of everything beneath them. You can see I have combination of both in left, but also faded my grass to their grass in right. The general rule of thumb is, you use the fading when we have two similar colors like the road, or it's very dark, like grasses on the right.
Sometimes we can use it to blend shadows as well.
Then we have two similar colors. The complexity is also important. You cannot fade two very different textures.
They go at each other.
Especially when it's bright. The road looks okay from this distance and above. Now take a look at this. This may seem okay, especially when you look at it as a whole, but if you want to be critical, you can see these two are not blended well. In reality, it would have been better instead of fading, I would continue the road to the left and use some shrub to cover what was behind.
Covered, covered, covered.
Just like how the house is covering background footage here. Trees also can be hard to blend. Unlike grass, grass can have different textures. It's normal. But trees? It's not about texture. It's also about depth and height. So when trying to blend two trees, slight difference would make it artificial and fake.
He couldn't get over how something so fake could look so real.
So, back to our current footage. Obviously, by putting the house here, we can simply cover what's behind, so they would blend well.
Same goes for the hillside buffer.
But for the trees here, we cannot simply blend. So we should cover what's in the drone footage. Generally, we need to cover a lot of foreground objects in the drone footage. And it's easy for trees. Default have great libraries of trees, so I can import and replace them, hopefully, with similar ones. But there are two types of trees here.
Sometimes we should care about top of them, like these trees. So trees that we put here should cover the top. Sometimes the bottom matters, like these trees here. And lastly, for these, we have to make sure it would fully cover the entire tree, and we need to worry about the top and the bottom.
But how can we know if we're placing our trees right, so it would cover what lies beneath? My idea is to use OnTop Replica. It's a free app which lets you to place a window or another window in Windows. You can download it from GitHub, link is in the description, and then install. When you open it, this is the interface. Now, what you should do is to place our video on top of D5 render. For this, right-click on OnTop Replica and choose 3ds Max. Next, what you want to do is to adjust the size so it would match perfectly with D5. You can also use a scroll on your mouse to slightly increase window size and further adjust it. Right click here and reduce opacity so you can check both of them. You may also have to make your D5 window smaller. Since both of them have 60:9 aspect ratio frames visible, can match them with ease. I would suggest entering advanced camera mode on D5 so it would stay at the same aspect ratio when you move or try to import assets. Now, there are two ways you can work with OnTop Replica. One is leaving it on top with low opacity. In this method, you can right click, go to advanced, and choose enable click through. This way, you can work on D5 and have main image on top. Later, you can select OnTop Replica from taskbar to click on it again. Second way is the right click on it, choose minimize, so it would go down and you can work on D5 and then later check the result by maximizing it. Now, with these in mind, place your vegetation in the scene. This part takes some time, and I like to do it with no care, so I'm going to fast forward it for you. First, added the trees I usually use, and once they're all in the scene, I try to place them roughly where the trees are located in the image, while looking at the image in my second monitor. Later, I bring on top Replica and adjust it to make sure it covers the trees. It may be a bit annoying, especially when it's dark in the image, and there are actually a lot of trees in here, but hopefully your project doesn't have this much trees. Also, remember, don't just trust the first frame of the animation. It's 3D space. Every once in a while, go to max, move the time indicator, and make sure all the places you want to be hidden remain hidden.
And I cannot stress enough how much dual monitor build can be helpful here. Not gonna lie, first time I did it for the project, I had only one monitor, and that was hard. Doable, obviously, but hard. Anyway, anytime you see changes in the on-top replica, I'm actually working on max off-camera, or off-screen recording to be correct. And don't try too hard here, especially for a project like this. It's very common to notice a tree is visible when you're mixing in next step, and you have to come back and render again. Annoying, yes, but camera matching is a valuable asset. So you may have to do hard things, things we do for best result. It seems good now. You can move on and hope for the best. This part took like half an hour for me. One more thing that needs to be covered is this area with orange road signs, which I use a vegetation path to cover. Same goes for the other side, which I've already covered with some trees. Now that we covered those parts, we should also match the shadows. I actually do have other views on the same location that are in the different footages that I've given you, so we would know there are some tall trees here providing shadows for these areas here. So I place a bunch of trees here to make similar shadows on the ground. The goal is to have correct shadows on these trees here and maybe the building. I know they look very weird, but hopefully they provide our required shadows to match more with the scene. The shadows over these trees are kind of mandatory because it continues here, but the shadows over the house is a nice touch. One more thing I want to mention is you should match the parts you're going to remove from render to what they really are in terms of color and lightness. For example, take a look at this area above vegetation. See, here it's bright, but if you look at the footage, it's dark. The mask we get from D5 is great, but it's normal they have inaccuracies for about a pixel or two. If I keep this area bright, it would have this bright stroke around it and it would make it look ugly. So to match them, I'm adding some trees here so their shadow would make it darker. Looks great. Now, with the scene ready, time to bring the camera back. Before that, I move the time indicator back to frame 0 and again update my scene here to make sure everything works great. Now I select the camera group and go here to D5 plugin in Max and send Karen camera animation to D5. Listen to me now, here's the trickiest part. When you open the animation in Max and play it, it looks good. But now, I select first shot, then I select the scene I created before here. Now, again, I select the first shot.
Such a small change.
Did you notice that small nudge? Believe it or not, that can be the killer of your hard work.
I'm telling you, this is the killer.
To fix it, I select the scene first. Now I update the first animation view accordingly. The good thing about camera path import is you can apply it based on the scene you want, and we want it to be accurate, so here, win.
I've never come so close to dying.
But don't just do it once. Check it a couple of times. The scene here and the first animation shot must be the same. Now we can start exporting. First, we're going to export a regular MP4 30fps. I choose 4K. I kind of always choose 4K. I know the render time is longer, but the quality is much better here. Size actually means quality in D5 render. And since the time difference is not really that much, I always recommend it.
next thing we want is our masks. The best option we have for now is a sky mask, which is black and white and works great in After Effects. And we want a mask for the house and the vegetation around it. But since they are all together, we create it all together. But if you want, you can render separate masks based on your scene. To make masks, first I make a copy of my clip. You don't want to remove your main clip if you needed any changes, right? Then I hide the ground, all the scatters, and leave out my house and all the vegetations I want to be at top. I press the update button for the first shot, then do the same for last frame as well. For render, I'll change the format to image sequence. If it's not here, you can go to preference, widgets, and activate advanced video rendering. This option requires post subscription, so if you don't have that, feel free to use the link in description to create an account and buy D5 with 5% discount. This way, not only you support a beloved D5 render, you also support me. A little. Actually, very little. But you can always buy me a coffee, I guess.
Well, money doesn't matter when it comes to making the little woman happy.
Alright, after choosing image sequence, click on channels and use sky mask. Then start rendering process. Honestly, if D5 is listening, this is not the most optimal way. Please add an object mask in channels, allowing us to select specific objects or layers and create black and white masks for them. This would make the process much faster and easier, not only on this, but in every post-production. I have posted a topic in Ideas and Requests explaining them in details. The link is in description. Please go vote if you also think this would be helpful.
I get your vote?
The main render and the mask renders would match 99% of times. But if you were unlucky, copy the main clip again and do the same. It has happened to me once in all my tries. And when I rendered again, it was fixed. I don't know what was wrong with that time. Now, with our outputs ready, let's go back to After Effects
and finish what we started.
Yeah. Don't forget to like the video and ask me any questions you have in the comment section. See you in the next one.